Traffic lights and crossroads, you lucky people. This is just the contents page. I have done a load of stuff here. Look at this. It goes all 2 pages of it. Bargain. Assumptions. You have read the priority system from my website. You have read one-way roads from my website. The traffic light sequence. Before we get going, we need to make sure that you know the standard traffic light sequence. Red means stop. Wait behind the stop line on the carriageway. Red and amber also means stop, but get ready. So get into gear and do your 3-mirror check. Do not pass through or start until green shows. Green means you may cross the stop line and go on if the way is clear. Take special care if you intend to turn left or right and give way to pedestrians who are crossing the road. Amber means stop at the stop line. You may go on only if the amber appears after you have crossed the stop line or are so close to it that to pull up might cause an accident. Therefore, on the approach to a light, make sure you know how close the vehicle behind you is. Otherwise, how will you know if you're likely to cause an accident? A green arrow may be provided in addition to the full green signal if movement in a certain direction is allowed before or after the green light phase. If the way is clear, you may go, but only in the direction shown by the arrow. You may do this regardless of what other lights may be showing. White light signals may be provided for trams. Up and down means go, left and right means stop, just so you know. I know the amber light means stop, but you could also think of it as get ready, I'm just about to change. If it's on its own, then it's getting ready to stop. If it's red and amber, then it's getting ready to go to green because the red light currently says stop. The green arrow. A green arrow means that traffic travelling in that direction gets to go early. If you had a lot of them all pointing in lots of directions, lay them on top of each other, you would end up with a green circle. A green circle therefore means that you can go in any direction, providing it's safe to go that way, of course. Pictured left, an arrow means that only some of you can go. Everyone else must stop, but people turning right can go early, providing their route is clear. Whether an arrow is displayed or not is to do with the phasing of the lights. Some traffic lights only use filter arrows at rush hour. This means that at weekends or out of rush hour, an arrow won't be displayed. You can still turn right if a green circle is displayed though. Some lights are direction specific. This light has a blue circle and white arrow, meaning go left, attached to it. In this particular instance, there is also a green arrow, but sometimes you could get a green circle. It could be either. When this traffic light goes green, it is only for people turning left. You usually get 3 or more lights per set. At normal main junctions, you get traffic lights in threes. 2 lights at the stop line and then a 3rd light further ahead. This is so that 1, you can still see a light if you stop a bit too far forward and can't see the first 2 anymore. And 2, so that if a light bulb stops working in one of them, there's still another 2 lights working to avoid confusion. In the above example, there are 3 lights for going left and another 3 for going ahead. Look for the arrows under the lights. If you have passed the stop line at the first set of lights and the lights change to red, you can still pass the 3rd light that is placed further ahead. Roadworks. Sometimes you get roadworks and you will see signs like these. This is the equivalent of the stop line at traffic lights. Sometimes they put this sign up and the single traffic light slightly further down the road. The traffic light is the equivalent of the 3rd light mentioned previously. If you have passed this sign when the traffic light changes to red, keep going through the roadworks. This means that one of the roads has traffic lights and the other doesn't. Non-controlled traffic can just filter into the controlled road when safe to do so. See the next topic regarding ways. How many ways? At traffic lights, and this includes temporary lights, you can get different way control. You have traffic flowing from different directions. Sometimes only one direction can move, other times multiple directions can be released at the same time. In the above examples, I have put in traffic lights that emulate three-way control. Traffic from three different directions get their own go. The above is two-way control. One road gets a go, then the other. At a crossroads, you can get two-way, three-way, or four-way junctions, like this. The actual order of the lights can vary, and depending on the day or time, you might get different light sequences. At crossroads, always assume that the road opposite you will be released to drive at you until you know better, i.e. assume two-way control. Keeps you alive. How to approach a traffic light. If it's a pedestrian crossing, look to see if the wait button has been pressed. This could be a little red circle or the wait sign. If it has been pressed, the lights will change at some point. It doesn't matter if someone is there or not. It's if they have pressed the button. If it's just normal traffic light, then assume that the light will change any second now. Check behind you. Always check how close the vehicle behind you is, because the highway code states you may go on only if the amber appears after you have crossed the stop line or are so close to it that to pull up might cause an accident. Pick your point of no return. How I do it. With time, based on speed and conditions, you will learn what distance you need to stop in. Let's say that today there is no car behind me. I feel I can stop before the traffic light if I brake at or before the red line area. I pick the join at the zigzag, and if I have passed that spot when the light changes to amber, then I will keep going. If I haven't passed it yet, I will stop. If there is a bike behind or a bus, then I can't suddenly stop or else they will hit me. I would pick the yellow line and apply the same stop or keep going thought process. A word of caution is that you must be realistic. You still can't jump a red traffic light. By using this technique, you'll avoid the problem of slowing at a green traffic light and also any indecision when the lights change. Pick your stopping point. Let's pretend that we need to stop at the red traffic light. As you approach a traffic light, the front of your car hides where the stop line is. It is very common for learners to stop too early or late and cross the line. Look at the stop line and see what it lines up with, in this instance the brick upright and railing end. Notice that you don't need to be very accurate. You now know that if you stop in line with the railing or brick upright, you'll be close to the line but won't have passed the line. Excellent! Crossroads. There are a number of different crossroads, and they behave differently. I am assuming that you have read my document called The Priority System on my website. A crossroad is the same as a T-junction, except it has a road opposite it. Just treat it the same as a T-junction. How to spot a junction. Seems obvious this one, but it isn't. Sure, if there are traffic lights, it's dead easy. But without traffic lights, the road can look like it's just going ahead and suddenly whoosh, a car flies across in front of you. The main signs. You get empty downward pointing triangles that warn you of upcoming junctions. They tell you of what type of junction is ahead. Please note, you must stop at a stop line, ideally near it. I recommend that you do not look for traffic until you have stopped. Failure to stop will result in breaking the law and subsequently your driving test. If this sign is in front of you, you must be in a side road approaching a main road. You'd better start slowing down. In fact, as it says there is a two-way road coming up, it wouldn't warn you of something you are already in. Therefore, you must be in a one-way street. Just lobbing it out there. These two signs tell you that you are passing side roads on your left and right, i.e. crossroads. Remember that the thicker line is the main road. Looking for clues. Ahead of us in this picture, the road looks like it just keeps going ahead, but there's a crossroad halfway down. Always keep looking for clues. 1. You usually get 5 white lines on the approach to a give way line or stop line. So if you see 10 white lines in the middle of the road ahead, you have 2 junction ends joining, i.e. side roads looking at each other. Alternatively, the main road sometimes has 10 white lines down the middle to highlight that there are side roads either side. 2. Look for curbstones starting to go left or right. It is even easier if you see yellow lines by the side of the road that go round the corner. 3. Look for cars crossing in front of you. 4. Look for red on signs. The give way sign is a unique downward pointing triangle. The stop sign is a unique octagon. They are bordered with red but are sometimes obscured by bushes. See point 7 below. 5. Look for the triangle on the road. It's a painted give way sign. 6. Look for the lines on the floor going across your path. 7. Look for the back of signs. In the picture you can see the back of a give way sign. If there's a give way sign, there must be the end of a road. You will often see the back of a sign on the other side of the road before you'll see your sign on the left. 8. Look for street names. They are usually at the entrance to a new road. 9. Look for the dead end or no through road sign. If you see this sign, it's because to carry on will result in you having to turn around. Logically, therefore, just before the sign, there must be a road that you can take to avoid going down a dead end. Rolo. Chocolate. No, not chocolatey caramel goodness, I'm afraid. Right opposite, left opposite. It's how you should look around when you're going across a junction. Just keep looking right, opposite, left, opposite, right, opposite, left, opposite, until you go. Remember, go if you can without scaring people. Approach slow, look around, and go when safe. Never block a junction. Or can you? When it comes to the junctions, you never want to block the road on your left if it prohibits people from turning across your path, i.e. turning right in or out of a side road. The yellow car has blocked the junction. Dark green and potentially pink have to now wait because of the inconsiderate driving of yellow and to a degree red truck. If an ambulance or fire engine turned up, someone could die due to the delays caused by ignorant, inconsiderate drivers. Here, anyone can leave or enter the side road, whilst the main road is waiting to get going again. Here, we have a traffic light controlled crossroad, but also a traffic jam. Yellow and red have gone across when the lights were green for them. Unfortunately, there wasn't room for them to clear the junction, so they stopped in the middle. The traffic lights then changed so that green and pink could go, but then we are met with gridlock. No one able to move through the stupidity of yellow and red. This is what yellow should have done. Waited at the stop line until they could fully cross the junction. Now there is no junction blocking when the lights change. There's always an exception, and here's an example of one. Sometimes you will get a raised curb in the middle of the road to stop people from turning right at a junction. In this instance, you can block the side road if you want. The decent thing to do would be to allow people out of the side road, but that is up to you in this instance. Notice the additional signs: no right turn, left turn ahead, and go left. In this instance, the side road must turn left. The sign says so. The main road isn't allowed to turn right into the side road, but an emergency vehicle could turn up and need access, so you need to keep the side road clear. Here we have the raised curb in the middle of the road again. You can block the side road if you want to. Whilst on the topic, the same principle of not blocking should be applied to any place on the left that people may wish to get from. This therefore includes, but is not limited to, pedestrian crossings, cycle paths, side roads, driveways, the islands in the middle of the road so people can cross a bit at a time. They're called pedestrian safety havens. Any situation where someone may wish to cross your path whilst you wait in traffic, keep it clear for them. Unmarked crossroad. These are tricky. No road signs, no road markings, no priority, hard to spot. There is no main road or side road, only roads. Someone might be approaching it, not even know it's there, and drive straight across it. Luckily, you usually get these in built-up areas, so speeds are generally quite low. Treat with extreme caution and go when you're happy you won't hit anyone. If it looks like two vehicles are going to cross each other's paths, then you should gain eye contact with the other driver and agree who should go first. Out of interest, you should treat a normal traffic light junction like this if the traffic lights are broken. More on that to come. Standard crossroads. Green and pink should give way to whatever is on the main road on their routes. Green and pink can only go out onto the main road if they're not going to cause someone to panic. Yellow gets priority over green and pink and can continue. Yellow should continue, but just keep an eye on the side roads like you would passing any side road, just in case someone on a bike comes out by accident, for instance. Pink and green are potentially going to clash when they emerge. There is no priority regarding two side roads. If pink and green aren't using the same bit of road, then they can go when they are happy it's safe. If green and pink are going to be sharing the same bit of road, they must gain eye contact and agree who should go first. If in doubt, don't emerge. Sometimes there's a turning area in the middle of the road. In this picture, there are two cycle paths, red, and three lanes, blue. You'll also see that the side roads are offset, so you have to be careful to ensure that you don't accidentally enter the road opposite in the exit lane. There is also a pathway marked for pedestrians and cycles, yellow. If you are in the side road, you can go across, but you have to make sure you have catered for all six places of risk. Rolo a lot and get your timing right so that as you go across, no one else has to panic. If you were crossing from left to right, for instance, you can consider doing some of the route at a time, e.g. drive slowly through parts 1 and 2, wait in 3 until 4, 5 and 6 are clear, then continue. You must make sure that you don't block people's routes along 1 and 2 whilst doing this though. If you are on the main road and want to turn right, treat it like a normal T-junction. In this example, there's a turning area in the middle of the road with broken white lines surrounding the hatched area. You are allowed to go in here, providing it is necessary and safe to do so. Well, you're the one driving, you decide if it's a good idea or not. I often drive through these because I get a much better position in the middle of the road and cars can easily pass either side of me. Traffic light controlled crossroads. I'm assuming that you understand about the number of ways that a traffic light can behave. If not, go back and read the earlier entry. You can see that this is either a two-way or three-way traffic light. Traffic from below and above have been released and all other roads have been held. Note that there is a turning area in the middle of the road. I have repainted the lines because they got worn away over time. You can see that the white car has stopped in this area to allow the oncoming red cars to pass. I have numbered each approach road so that you know which one I'm talking about on the following page. Approaching from 1. There are two lanes on approach. You use the left lane to go left or ahead, paint has been worn away, or the right lane to turn right. If the light is red, all lanes must stop near the stop line. A. When it goes green, you may proceed left or ahead from the left lane, or turn right from the right lane. You can see the van, B, waiting to turn right when traffic stops coming from ahead. You must assume that oncoming traffic has been released as well. If you were the waiting van, you would see something like this. There is a fourth light under the green light, C. This is a filter light. This filter light will only come on after the oncoming traffic gets a red light. Don't forget though that depending on the day or time, the filter light may not come on at all. You can go when 1. The filter light comes on with a green arrow pointing right, still checking oncoming traffic is slowing or stopped though. 2. The traffic ahead stops coming at you, i.e. a gap in the traffic. 3. Your traffic light has turned red, providing that you have passed the stop line at the first traffic light A. If you have managed to get to the middle of the junction, then you are allowed to clear it when safe. If you haven't passed the stop line at the first traffic light and the light turns red again, you have to wait until it turns green again and then move to the middle. 4. There's nothing blocking your exit, like a pedestrian crossing the road. Approaching from 2. There's only one lane from here. Stop near the stop line if lights are red. Go in any direction you like when they go green. If turning right, wait in the central turning area A until oncoming traffic stops coming at you, if it comes at all. Watch those pedestrians as well. Approaching from 3. 2 lanes, left for going left, right for going ahead or right. Notice there is a left turn filter arrow that may or may not come on. You can turn left when you see the arrow or a green circle. You may go ahead or right when you get the green circle. Just remember to ensure there is no oncoming vehicle when turning right and no pedestrians blocking your exit. Approaching from 4. Only one lane. Go in any direction when green. Look for oncoming traffic when turning right and pedestrians when you exit. Doesn't really matter which direction you're going, just don't run over people, please. Turning right at traffic lights, generally. I assume that you will stop at the stop line when the traffic light is red, just like red truck. Pink and green can both turn right because there is no oncoming traffic in their way. Pink can turn. Green has a green light and so has moved up to the turning area in the middle. There's a big gap between yellow and blue, so green could turn between them. Unfortunately, there's a pedestrian in the way, so green can't turn, otherwise he would block blue. If the pedestrian wasn't there, green could have turned. Blue now has a red light. Pink can still turn. Green can turn because they have a green filter arrow and blue has slowed or stopped and green's exit is clear because the pedestrian has cleared the road. Green has been waiting in the central turning area. The traffic lights changed to allow traffic from the side roads to go. Because green was stationary after the stop line, they can clear the junction as soon as they are happy that blue is stopping. Yellow box junctions. You see yellow box junctions at places where we really do not want people stopping, like near fire, ambulance, police stations, or tram lines, bus routes, etc. Personally, I treat all junctions like yellow box junctions because it's just common sense. If there's a yellow box junction, there's probably a camera looking at you to send you a fine when you're being an idiot. Let's be honest here, anyone who blocks a junction is being an idiot. See the previous section on not blocking junctions. The rules are: 1. Never enter a yellow box junction unless there is room for your car on the other side of it. Don't anticipate that there will be room for you by the time you get there. There must be room for your car right now, before you even enter the box. If you follow someone into a box junction and they stop earlier than you expected, you will have to stop in an area you have expressly been told to keep clear. Expect a fine or a fail if you're doing your driving test. Good. Haven't entered the box yet. There isn't room to clear the box. Bad. If red stops, green will be stuck in the box. Good. Green only enters the box when there is room after the box. Bad. Red car enters box before they can exit. If red van stops early, red car is in the box. 2. You can stop in a box junction when turning right, but 1. Your exit must have been clear before you entered it. 2. You can't currently turn right because there's oncoming traffic stopping you from turning. Good. Green is waiting to turn right and his exit is clear. Bad. Green can't exit the junction when oncoming traffic stops coming at them. They should not have entered the box. Note. A. You can find yourself in a box junction waiting to turn right into a side road. This is fine. B. Oncoming traffic turns left into your intended road and then stops. C. You are now stationary in a box junction, unable to exit through no fault of your own. Hence why it's worded, you're not allowed to enter a junction. Do you go ahead or wait? D. I can't find anything that states what you should do in this instance. My suggestion is to assess the situation. If the cars have stopped because of a slight delay, like a pedestrian crossing the road or someone reversing into their driveway, then wait and go when clear. If the delay is likely to be longer, like roadworks, then find an alternative route. The spirit of the box is go away and leave this clear for emergency access. So drive accordingly. What if the traffic lights fail? Crossroad with side roads. This road is marked with turning areas which imply that the road going up down is the main road. Because the lights have failed, there is no actual priority, but because it is marked this way, people will assume there is a priority system. The side roads can enter the road like they would at any non-traffic light controlled road. Go when it's safe, but treat the whole thing with caution regardless of where you are coming from. Crossroad with no side roads. With broken traffic lights, there is no main road as such, just a busy junction. Treat this like an unmarked crossroad. Drive on your route when you're not going to hit anyone. Keep looking around and gain eye contact can often help. I've had people stop to let me out of junctions before. One-way roads. There's always exceptions, but right lane for turning right, left lane for turning left. Going ahead could be either lane depending on road markings or signage. In this example, left lane is for ahead and left, right lane for turning right. Every junction is different though, so keep looking for markings and signs. The arrows are to help you see what is going on. Traffic coming from A, B, C or D can go into lanes 1, 2 or 3. Note, traffic from A, C and D can pick either lanes 2 or 3 depending on where they are going. The issue is that normally when you are turning right, you turn right when A, traffic stops driving at you, or B, you get a green filter arrow pointing right. In one-way streets, D would get a left filter arrow and C would get a right filter arrow, both at the same time. This means that traffic will drive at each other, which is freaky first time you see this happen. In this instance, D would go to 2 and C would go to 3. And then you do lane changing if you need to. See the following pictures. A goes to either 1 or 2. B goes to either 3 or 4. C goes to either 3 or 4. And D goes to either 1 or 2. Notice the silver car is doing a subsequent lane change. It also looks like the silver van and red car also want to swap places. Positioning for offset stroke staggered junctions. Not all junctions line up, sometimes they are offset. You need to consider the most convenient way of getting across. Important note, you must ensure that you leave the side road in the exit and enter the other road in the entrance. Do not cut corners. Indicate right then left. Just treat it like two junctions and do each part when safe. Yellow line is good. Red line is bad and will result in a failure on the driving test because you're entering a road in the exit. If the main road is busy, you might consider crossing the road in two sections. Yellow lines are the first part, wait for it to be clear, then do the red lines. Offside and near side turning. Normally, when you park a car, you park on the left. You therefore park near the curb, so the left side of the car is known as the near side. The right is therefore the offside. I know, surely it should be far side, shouldn't it? It's apparently from horse riding and knights with long swords. Because most people are right-handed, the sword used to hang on the left so that they could grab the handle with your right hand and whip it out and slay the dragon. With a sword hanging down the left of you, you would not be able to throw your left leg over a horse as the sword would get in the way. Knights would stand to the left of the horse and throw their right leg over the top. This means the left side of the horse would be near the mounting block, and if they mucked it up, they fell off the right side. See? The sword is on its left side. Would I lie to you? No, is the answer, by the way, just in case you wondered. Even today, people still get on a horse to the left of it. So the left side of the horse is near the block, and if this lady falls off, it'll be on the right side. It's just a terminology thing, but in car life, you will often hear mechanics talking about an NSR, or near side rear, or OSF, offside front, puncture. So now you know what they're talking about. So, who cares? Why am I telling you this? Read on, dear reader. Turning with someone else. If you have a narrow road like this, normally one of you stays back to allow the other to turn first. Just agree between the pair of you who should go first. If you were able to go around each other, this would be offside to offside turning. In wider roads, there could be a cyclist coming around behind the other car, so make sure to cater for that. This picture shows near side to near side turning because both cars are able to turn safely and have no need to get in each other's way. Sometimes you get arrows on the floor that show you what you should do, but be careful. This junction in Fleet shows that traffic should turn right by passing offside to offside. You need to consider not blocking other traffic when you do, and not running over those pesky pedestrian, cyclist, children, etc. Yellow is stupid. Blue can't get through because yellow has blocked their path. Pink is sensible and allows light green to turn right. Light green must cater for vehicles coming down the side of pink, the lorry. Light green must also consider any pedestrians under the tree. Once light green moves, yellow can move forward, blue can then turn right, and pink can replace blue. Grey lorry or red may still go to the side of yellow, so this is something that blue will have to consider, as well as bikes, pedestrians, etc. multiple layers of problems. This is an example of going across the main road in Fleet and your considerations that you should have. A. Speed limit change on the approach to the junction. Because 30 is the default speed limit in built-up areas, we must be leaving a different speed limit. If we were already in a 30, the limit signs wouldn't be there. B. You can see a 20 sign on the floor upside down, so we must be leaving a 20. C. There is a give way sign, but someone has rotated it so we can't see it properly. Probably someone returning from the pub thought this was a hilarious one night. This problem is quite common. In fact, the 30 sign on the right is often turned round to say 20 at this junction. You will need to learn to adapt or to ignore signs like this. D. There's a speed bump and give way triangle on the floor trying to slow you down and warn you of a junction. E. There's a car crossing your path, meaning there must be a junction there. F. There's a pub on my left, which means pedestrians could be just about to appear at the end of the road and walk into my path. G. Now we have traffic coming from our right and left to consider. H. Pedestrians, cyclists in the road opposite. I. Cyclists or pedestrians stepping into our path from the left and right on this side of the road and opposite. Here's the same junction but from above. We're going in the direction of the yellow arrow. A. You could have change in speed limits on the approach to the junction or in your new road. Remember to always look into your new road for danger and signs before you enter a road. B. Pedestrians could appear around the corner and walk in front of your car. Once you move up to the line to improve your view, they could then walk behind you. So make sure you don't roll backwards before you pull off. C. You have vehicles, cars, lorries, motorbikes, cyclists, from your left. D. You have vehicles, cars, lorries, motorbikes, cyclists, from your right. E. Pedestrians, cyclists could move into the road opposite as you cross. Just as a word of caution, if you get a load of stationary traffic on the main road, don't forget that bicycles or motorbikes can still come through the traffic. Just because you can't see them doesn't mean they aren't there. Something to reflect on. Reflections can be a very useful tool when you are driving. In this picture, you can see the reflection of the car in the window. Imagine there are cars between us and the blue car ahead. The white ones I've pasted in. You would not be able to see the blue car move off, and so you might be caught unprepared when a line of traffic moves off. If you are using shop windows, however, you could see the car move off, even though you can't directly see the car. Just in case you can't see the car reflection, here it is in large. Look, that blue thing with the white roof.